Good news, everyone! It's time for a new episode of Make a Space. This episode, we're going 3,000 years into the future for this lovable robot. So if you're ready, it's time to bite a shiny metal ass. Well, there's genuine ass bite marks on here now. Damn, that makes it worth a lot more.
Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be printing Bender from Futurama, one of my favorite characters. I found this model on my mini factory, and I thought it would be quite interesting to print, so I've downloaded the STL files. I'll link all of these models down in the description below that you guys can find it yourself. The model comes into four different sections, or actually three, just one arm, a main body, and some legs, and the base. You would just need to duplicate the arm, that you would be able to get two arms that you can print from either side of his body. Okay, I'm going to be opening the arms first. Cure is already open, so I'm just pulling the one arm in. Okay, so I'm going to be selecting the arm, and I'm going to multiply it by one, because we need two arms. I'm going to move them off to the side. I will rearrange them now. You don't have to, but I want to. I'm going to be pulling in the other items, the main body. Okay, so as you can see, it's laying down, and that's not the best position to print it in. So what I'm going to be doing is selecting the item, and I'm going to be rotating it that he faces upwards, that there's a lot less overhangs, because all of these items, or how he's laying at the moment, there's a lot of overhangs. So I'm going to be selecting the model. I'm going to be rotating him. You'll see that there's a couple of lines that appear. If you start dragging on them, they'll rotate in that direction. So I'm going to be trying to move him forward, so I'm going to select on the green line, and as you can see, if I hold down the mouse and drag him forward, he'll just snap to the build plate. So I'm going to shift him over. I'm going to be trying to print all the models at once. The last piece would be the legs and the base. Okay, so let's bring that in. As you can see, it imported not particularly the right way that I want to try and print, so I'm going to try and rotate this one as well. Go down here, select rotate. As soon as that comes up, you'll see the same lines appear. I'm going to be dragging on that all the way around, and then once you let go, it'll automatically snap to the build plate. I'm just going to rotate this one last time just to get the wording and everything facing the camera's way. Okay, so we're going to be shifting this over a little bit. Okay, sorry, one more shift. Okay, so I'm just gonna try and move these a little bit, give it a little bit better spacing. I'm gonna select this one and just change it that it looks like his arms, how they would be inserted into the body. So this is how I'm gonna actually print all of the items. I'm gonna leave everything pretty much standard. I don't really change much of the options. 20% is more than sufficient. I'm going to be selecting the support structures as everywhere, because there's a couple overhangs that would need to be supported by the structures. I'll be using the platform, the platforms as in rafts, that these arms don't break free when the print is printing. This section over here is alright. It's got quite a large base, so I'm not too worried about that. Bender, I suppose, needs also a bit of a raft. He might come loose once we start printing. As you can see, it's going to take around about 8 hours. It's going to consume about 6 meters of filament, and the cost is going to be about 30 rand South African. I'll link the exchange rate that you guys can see what this would cost if you had to print it in your own currency. So I'm going to just save it off to your SD card now, put it into the printer, and then we're going to be starting to see the time lapse right now. I'm Bender. Hey guys, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed that time lapse. The next step is to clean this bender up, so we're going to need a couple of tools. Okay, so I'm going to be using a couple of small files. I'm going to be using different levels of sandpaper, very fine sandpaper all the way down to very rough sandpaper, to get the 3D print very smooth and any imperfections being removed. I'm going to be using two other tools, some side cutters, as well as needle nose pliers to break off any support structures. I'm also going to be using a carpenter's knife. So let's get to it. Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching this week's video. I hope you really enjoyed it. If you liked the video, please be sure to give me a thumbs up down below. And remember to share it with all your friends and family. Click on the subscribe button to stay up to date with all our new videos as they get released. If you have something you want me to print, leave it down in the comment section below and I'll be sure to add it to my print list. If you haven't seen our previous videos, you can click on them now, or you can find a link in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you in the next Makerspace.
If you're ready, then it's time to buy a shiny metal ass. Ah, clink!